Welcome everyone to Affairs Cloud. How are you all? My name is Vikas and today we'll be discussing some of the important current affairs that will help you to enhance your performance for the upcoming government exams or any other exams. So before that, you should know that we have an app by the name Careers Cloud, which you can go and download in the Play Store. In the Careers Cloud app, if you see and go and look in the current affairs section, you can see the courses provided by us for 1 year and 2 year. Either option you can choose. Both are up to the mark. Okay, in that courses, we provide you with the daily current affairs, PDF of daily current affairs, then the quizzes of those current affairs that has contains 20 questions. Okay, then ebook we provide you with that. Along that, you can see we also provide you weekly current affairs. The all the important current affairs that are important for your preparation are covered in the weekly PDF provided to you. We have a quiz in that also that is of 50 questions. Similarly, for the month, we provide you monthly PDF where all the important ones are covered in that particular PDF along with the ebook and the quizzes we provide you. Alright, then apart from that, if you want to purchase the course, you can use the course code VIKAS10 to get a 10% discount on the purchase made. Okay, then apart from the current affairs and the daily, monthly and weekly PDF, you can also see the courses available on our app is for banking and various alag courses, okay, such as banking. Then we provide you in banking the monthly banking and economic quiz. There you can see the exam PDF that will help you to for all your upcoming exams. Then you can see that in our course we provide you topic wise current affairs, such as you just saw the last yesterday's videos in which we covered indexes and reports. Similarly, there are many more topics to be left to be covered. Okay, so all these topic wise PDFs are also provided you in the course. Okay, the courses are of two types, one for 1 year and for the 2 year. If you are an aspirant for the particular year, this year you can opt for the course for 1 year. But if you have just started the preparation and you think that it will take around a year or two for your preparation, then you can directly purchase the course for 2 year. And in both the courses, you can use the code VIKAS10 to get a straight 10% discount. This is the code, we bought the code just for you to help, you know, to lower the amount or lower the burden on the students so they can do their preparation in a justified amount. So let's start with our video for the day. In today's video, we'll be looking at the important weekly current affairs of the second week of March 2021. Okay, so the first question is, which organization signed an MOU with the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare for implementing agroforestry under the submission on agroforestry? So which organization signed MOU with the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare for agroforestry? It was Central Silk Board. It was your Central Silk Board. Okay, then if we talk about the Cotton Corporation of India, Cotton Corporation of India, where is the headquarter of Cotton Corporation of India? It is in Mumbai. Okay, then moving on to the next question. Next question is, India topped in technology and innovation report. India topped in technology and innovation report 2021 as the biggest overperformer in frontier technologies among countries with similar per capita GDP. Which organization released the report? So it is asking the name of the organization that released the report. And what is the name of the report? It is Technology and Innovation Report 2020. India topped in it. Who released this report? It was released by UNCTAD, that is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Where is the headquarter of UNCTAD? The headquarter is in Geneva. And where is Geneva? It is in Switzerland. Okay, Switzerland. When was UNCTAD developed, or when this organization started? It was started in 1964. Okay, then if we talk about International Labour Organization, its headquarter is also in Geneva, Switzerland. And if we talk about International Electrotechnical Commission, the main motto of IEC, the main motto of IEC is making electrotechnology work for you. Making electrotechnology work for you. Okay, this is the motto of IEC. Then India is the biggest performers in technology than its GDP. You should know this. This is one of the important that India is the biggest overperformer in the frontier technologies among the countries with similar per capita GDP. Okay, moving on to the next. Next question is, what is the India's rank? What is the India's rank in UNCTAD B2C e-commerce index 2020 that measures economic preparedness of the countries to support online shopping? I repeat, what is India's rank in UNCTAD B2C e-commerce index 2020 that measures economic preparedness of the countries to support online shopping? Okay, so first you should know the rank. India stand at 71st place. The rank of India is 71st. Then we saw the full form of UNCTAD. Okay, then what is the full form of B2C? B2C, this stands for business to customers. Business to customer. Okay, this index you should know is topped by, means the rank one goes to Switzerland. It is topped by Switzerland. All right. So in UNCTAD B2C e-commerce index, India's rank was 71st. Next question. Next question is, which bank launched Startup Unity, a mentoring program for women entrepreneurs? I repeat, which bank started Startup Unity, a mentoring program by the women for women entrepreneurs? This was started by HDFC Bank. Okay, this was started by HDFC Bank, and here the senior women in HDFC Bank will mentor the young entrepreneurs or the women entrepreneurs to help them start their business. Okay, also you should know HDFC recently released Muh Band Rakho to scheme. This was the name of a scheme launched by HDFC, and this is to control the social frauds. Okay, online frauds and all types of frauds. Muh Band Rakho, HDFC Bank started it. And Startup Unati is a scheme launched by HDFC Bank for mentoring the women and the senior leaders, or the senior women leaders of HDFC Bank will mentor the young entrepreneur women. Okay, the questions we will be discussing today are more very important, and I would like you to all like the video ASAP and subscribe to the channel, because when you will do the same, it will motivate us to bring more and more and very good content for you guys. Okay, so it helps us a lot. Do subscribe and like the channel, and do hit a like on all the videos. Okay, let's start with the next question. Which country won the test tournament Anthony De Melo Trophy? I repeat, which country won the test tournament Anthony De Melo Trophy in March 2021? Who won it? It was won by, first you should know, this game was held between India and England. Okay, India and England. Who won it? And it was won by India. Okay, it was won by India. Where did it took place? It was held in the largest cricket stadium, which is our Narendra Modi Cricket Stadium. Okay, and it was earlier known as Motera Stadium. All right, then who has been awarded as the player of the series? Player of the series title has been awarded to Ravi Chandra Ashwin. Okay, player of the series. Then next question. Also, you should know in this, here India won by 3-1. Okay, 3-1. Next question. Who became the first player in the test cricket to take 200 wickets against left-handed batsmen? I repeat, This, the name of the person is Ravi Chandra Ashwin. He has been awarded as the player of the series, Ravi Chandra Ashwin. Okay, then you should know that Ravi Chandra Ashwin is a spinner bowler. He's a spinner, and he made three records in this series. All the three records are first. सेकेंड फास्टर बॉलर टू टेक 400 सेकेंड फास्टर बॉलर टू टेक 400 टेस्ट विकेट ओके सेकेंड फास्टेस्ट बॉलर टू टेक 400 टेस्ट विकेट्स ओके एंड ही जस्ट टुक 77 मैचेस टू डू द सेम ओके एंड द फर्स्ट फास्टेस्ट बॉलर टू टेक 400 विकेट्स वॉज मुथैया मुरलीधरन हु डिड दिस इन ओनली 72 मैचेस ओके सो फर्स्ट वॉज मुथैया मुरलीधरन सेकेंड इज आर रविचंद्र अश्विन विद 77 मैचेस ओके देन द सेकेंड रिकॉर्ड दैट ही मेड वॉज द फर्स्ट बॉलर विद 200 विकेट्स इन टेस्ट अगेंस्ट लेफ्ट हैंडेड बैट्समैन एज द क्वेश्चन सेज ओके एंड द थर्ड रिकॉर्ड दैट ही मेड वॉज द फर्स्ट इंडियन क्रिकेटर टू पिक 30 विकेट्स और मोर इन टेस्ट सीरीज 30 विकेट्स और मोर इन टेस्ट सीरीज ही एंड दिस इज फॉर इंडियन क्रिकेटर ओके सो लेट्स रिवाइज इट वंस अगेन फर्स्ट प्लेयर इन टेस्ट क्रिकेट टू टेक 200 विकेट्स अगेंस्ट लेफ्ट हैंडेड बैट्समैन वॉज रविचंद्र अश्विन ही वॉज द सेकेंड फास्टेस्ट बॉलर टू टेक 400 टेस्ट विकेट्स एंड फर्स्ट वॉज मुथैया मुरलीधरन एंड ही ऑल्सो स्कोर वॉज द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू टेक 30 विकेट्स और मोर इन अ टेस्ट सीरीज ओके मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट ओके मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज द थीम ऑफ 2021's International Women's Day that is annually celebrated by the United Nations on 8th of March. What is the theme of the International Women's Day that was celebrated on 8th of March? Tell me the name of the theme. What is the theme? The theme is very good. Comment below fast. Give me the answer. The theme is Women in Leadership. Okay. Women in Leadership achieving an equal future in COVID-19 world. I repeat, women in leadership achieving an equal future in a COVID-19 world. Okay, then you should know that India ranked third with 39% of women in senior management. Okay, ranked third in 39% of women in senior management. Okay, moving on to the next. Next question is, Where is India's first World Skills Center? India's first World Skills Center, an advanced skill training institute that was developed under the assistance of Asian Development Bank. Where it has been made? India's first World Skills Center, which is being made with the help of Asian Development Bank. Okay, where it is being built? It is being built in where? Bhuvaneshwar, Odisha. It is being built in Bhuvaneshwar, Odisha. If we talk about ADB, where is the headquarter of ADB? It is in Manila, Philippines. Okay, Manila, Philippines. Then you should know who is the Chief Minister of Odisha. Chief Minister of Odisha. He is none other than Naveen Patnaik. Okay, then the project for this India's first silk skill center will be cost is around 1340 crore. Okay. Then you should know the under Odisha Skill Development Project Center development with the assistance of ADP and ITEES. This is developed with Asian Development Bank as the question says. Along with you should know it is being developed with the help of ITEES. They both are developing or ADB will also work. Okay, this is just an additional information. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which country leased 4 Heron TP unmanned air vehicle to Indian Army for 3 years? I repeat, which country leased 4 Heron TP unmanned air vehicles to Indian Army for 3 years? Okay, first you should know that what is Heron TP unmanned air vehicle. This is your MALE. First thing, what is MALE? MALE UAV. MALE is medium altitude long endurance. Medium altitude long endurance. Okay. MALE UAV. UAV your unmanned air vehicle. So this 4 MALE UAV was given on a lease to Indian Army for 3 years by which country? It was given to us by Israel. ओके, इट वॉज गिवन टू अस बाय इजराइल. ऑल्सो यू शुड नो दैट ऑल द थ्री फोर्सेज ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज एयरफोर्स, आर्मी एंड नेवी, कैन परचेज वेपन्स फ्रॉम अदर कंट्री अंडर एमरजेंसी पावर्स. ओके, एमरजेंसी पावर मीन्स इफ देर इज सिचुएशन ऑफ एमरजेंसी और देर इज एनर्जी एमरजेंसी पावर बिल पास, देन ऑल द थ्री फोर्सेज कैन परचेज वेपन्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कंट्रीज अंडर दिस प्रोविजन. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज वॉट इज द इंडियाज रैंक इन 2021 इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम इंडेक्स रिलीज बाय द हेरिटेज फाउंडेशन. टू थिंग्स यू शुड रिमेंबर अबाउट दिस, दैट 2021 इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम इंडेक्स इज रिलीज बाय हेरिटेज फाउंडेशन. ओके, इट इज रिलीज बाय हेरिटेज फाउंडेशन. ओके, एंड द रैंक ऑफ इंडिया वॉज 121. इट वॉज कंसिडर्ड अंडर द कैटेगरी मोस्टली अनफ्री. ओके, देन यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस इज द 27th एडिशन ऑफ द रिपोर्ट. This is the 27th edition of the report and it is given by which foundation? The Heritage Foundation. Rank 1 of in this Economic Freedom Index was by Singapore. It was secured by Singapore. Okay, then you should also remember that Singapore topped this second time. Okay, in a row. Then apart from this, you should remember Hong Kong used to win this title or used to secure the first position in your Economic Freedom Index, but this year it has been excluded. Okay, and also Hong Kong has won 25 times or secured the position one for 25 times in the 27 years of tenure. Okay, so this report has been released by 27 times and out of that 25 times Hong Kong secured it, but this time it has been excluded and it has been topped by Singapore. Okay, next question is which small finance bank launched Garima saving accounts, a special saving accounts for women that provides a maximum interest of 7%. I repeat, which small finance bank launched Garima saving accounts, that is a special saving account for women that provides a maximum interest rate of 7%. So what is the name of the finance bank? It is the Ujjivan Small Finance Bank. Who is the MD and CEO of Ujjivan Small Finance Bank? He is Nitin Chugh. What is the tagline of the bank? The tagline is Build a Better Life. Okay, and where is the headquarter? The headquarter is in Bangalore, Karnataka. With Karnataka, you should remember this is the most innovative state. Karnataka is the most innovative state. Okay, then next question is which RRB launched a new loan scheme by the name Vikas Asha that provides loans up to 10 lakh to women entrepreneurs? I repeat, which RRB launched a new loan scheme by the name Vikas Asha that provides a loan up to 10 lakh rupees to women entrepreneurs? So who appoints or who launched it? It was launched by Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. Next question is Nisar, a synthetic, important one, okay, Nisar, a synthetic aperture radar, is a joint earth observation satellite mission of ISRO and DASH. So Nisar, what is Nisar? First thing you should know that Nisar is what? NISAR. Okay, first do this. N for NASA, I for ISRO. Okay, it is a joint venture or a joint earth observation satellite mission of ISRO and NASA. So the question has been answered from here. Then what is SAR? S-A-R. SAR stands for synthetic aperture radar. Okay, synthetic aperture radar. Okay, this is been developed by ISRO. Is being developed by ISRO and it is capable of producing high resolution images. SAR is capable of producing, you should know this, high resolution images. Okay, SAR. Then NISAR, you should remember, as I said, once let's do it again, NISAR, NASA ISRO Synthetic Aperture Radar. Okay, the target to launch this is 2022. Okay, and this will be launched from Sriharikota. Sriharikota, which is in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, moving on to the next. In March 2021, Anushman Singh, the former governor of Dash, passed away. Anushman Singh, the former governor of which state, passed away? He was from Rajasthan. Okay. Then if we look at some of the important schemes launched by Rajasthan, was Mukhya Mantri Yuva Sambal Yojana. Okay. Mukhya Mantri Yuva Sambal Yojana. Another was ABMGRSBY. What is ABMGBRSBY? This stands for Ayushman Bharat Mahatma Gandhi Rajasthan Suraksha Bima Yojana. Okay, I repeat, Ayushman Bharat Mahatma Gandhi Rajasthan Suraksha Bima Yojana. Okay, apart from this, another was launched Nishulk Sanitary Napkins Distribution Scheme. Nishulk Sanitary Napkins Distribution Scheme launched by Rajasthan. Then if we talk about UP, UP started Rojgar Mela. First Rojgar Mela, you should know. Then UP started UP Shadi Andan Yojana. UP Shadi Anudan Yojana. Third was Berojgari Bhatta. Berojgari Bhatta was given by UP to their labors and other. Okay, Berojgari Bhatta. Then the last one was UP Bhagya Lakshmi Yojana. UP Bhagya Lakshmi Yojana. Rojgar Mela, UP Shadi Anudan Yojana, Berojgari Bhatta, and UP Bhagya Lakshmi Yojana. Okay, then coming back to the question, Anshuman Singh, the former governor of Rajasthan, passed away. Also, you should remember about Sikkim, that Sikkim was the only state that was excluded from LASI Wave 1 report. Okay, it was the largest kind of survey in India and the first type of survey in the world. Okay, you should know about LASI Wave report. We have covered this in the indexes and report video. You should go and check that out. Okay, moving on to the next. Next is, which state UT became the first in India to incorporate gender budget in its annual budget aimed at providing better services to women? I repeat, which state or UT became the first in India to incorporate gender budget in its annual budget aimed at providing better services to women? So what is the name of the state? It is Andhra Pradesh. Who is the CM of Andhra Pradesh? It is Y.S. Jagan Reddy. Okay, then they also launched a scheme by the name Swechha. What is this? It is the awareness program to create awareness about the menstrual hygiene. Swechha is to create awareness about the menstrual hygiene. Okay, next question is, which organization partnered with Rocky Mountain Institute? I repeat, which organization partnered with Rocky Mountain Institute? Rocky Mountain Institute of India to release mobilizing financing for EVs in India. I repeat, which organization partnered with Rocky Mountain Institute to release mobilizing finance for EVs, that is electric vehicles in India report that analyzes the Indian electric vehicle market's potential. So which organization partnered with Rocky Mountain Institute to release a report on mobilizing finance for EVs that analyzes the electric vehicle market potential in India? It was released by Niti Aayog. Okay, it was released by Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog came up in 2015. Earlier, it used to be known as Planning Commission. ओके, देर इज अ होमवर्क फॉर यू गाइज, यू हैव टू टेल मी वेर इज द नेशनल डेवलपमेंट काउंसिल. ओके, वॉट इज नेशनल डेवलपमेंट काउंसिल, और इफ देर इज अ हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ इट वेर इट इज. वेन वॉज एनडीसी सेटअप, वेन वॉज एनडीसी सेटअप. ओके, आंसर मी दीज क्वेश्चन, कमेंट बिलो, आई विल बी चेकिंग योर आंसर्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच कंपनी साइंड एन MOU विद इंडियन नेवी फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ 11 एम्यूनेशन कम टॉर्पेडो कम मिसल बार्जेस. आई रिपीट, विच कंपनी साइंड एन MOU विद इंडियन नेवी, विच कंपनी, नेम ऑफ द कंपनी इज बींग आस्क, दैट साइंड एन MOU विद इंडियन नेवी फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ 11 एम्यूनेशन कम टॉर्पेडो कम मिसल बार्जेस. सो वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी, द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी इज सूर्यदीप्ता प्रोजेक्ट, सूर्यदीप्ता projects. Okay, then you should know that this, according to this, by making 11 ammunition cum torpedo cum missiles, India has achieved another milestone for India's government Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India, Make in India scheme, Atmanirbhar Bharat also. So this will be made in India. Okay, moving on to the next, 18th question is, which country recently became the first in Europe to conduct a military exercise in space named Aster X? Recently, Aster X was a name of the military exercise that was conducted in space. Okay, and it is the first in Europe to conduct a military exercise. So, what is the name of the country? The name of the country is France. Name of the country is France. And Aster X, this has been taken from the name of the first satellite of France that was launched in 1965. Okay, and the name of the satellite was Aster X. Okay, Aster X IX. All right, so also you should know this is a five day long exercise by the name Aster X, and it was done by France. All right, moving on to the next. If you are enjoying and liking the questions, then do like the button and do like the video. Okay, also sometimes you guys will, nowadays you won't be getting, you know, notification that we have uploaded a video. So please go and subscribe, also tick on the bell icon, so whenever we upload a video or there we are going live for a we are teaching, then you will be getting a direct notification for that. Okay, so tick the bell also, then it is important for you guys to get notification. Coming back to our video, the 19th question is, which bank recently partnered with Aqua Connect to provide Kisan credit cards to aquaculture farmers? I repeat, which bank recently partnered with Aqua Connect to provide Kisan credit cards to aquaculture farmers? What is the name of the bank? The name of the bank is Bank of Baroda. The name of the bank is Bank of Baroda. Also, they have extended loan up to 10 lakh rupees under KCC. Under KCC. What is KCC? KCC stands for Kisan Credit Card. Kisan Credit Card. Okay. Then you should know Kisan Credit Card came in 1998. Okay, and this was launched, Kisan credit card was launched by NABARD. What is NABARD? You should know then. NABARD is the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. Okay, then moving on to the next. 20th question is saying, what is the projected GDP growth of India for fiscal year 2022 as per the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development as of March 2021? What is the growth of India for fiscal year 2021 as per the OECD, that is Economic Organization for Economic and Cooperation and Development? I repeat, projected GDP for the fiscal year 22 as per the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, that is OECD. What is the projected percentage? It is 12.6%. It is 12.6%. So moving on to the next question. Next is, who recently became the 9th CM of Uttarakhand? Who became the 9th Chief Minister of Uttarakhand? Who is he? He is Tirath Singh Rawat. He is तीरथ सिंह रावत, ओके, उत्तराखंड 9th CM. देन भूपेश बघेल, ही इज द CM ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़, ही इज द CM ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़. त्रिरेंद्र सिंह रावत, उत्तराखंड. पेमा खंडू, पेमा खंडू इज द CM ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश, ओके, अरुणाचल प्रदेश. नीफू रियो, नीफू रियो इज द CM ऑफ नागालैंड, इज द CM ऑफ नागालैंड. ओके, मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सक्सेसफुली डेवलप्ड अ प्रोटोटाइप ऑफ एयर इंडिपेंडेंट प्रोपल्शन सिस्टम फॉर सबमरीन्स. आई रिपीट, विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सक्सेसफुली डेवलप्ड अ प्रोटोटाइप ऑफ एयर इंडिपेंडेंट प्रोपल्शन सिस्टम फॉर सबमरीन्स. इट वॉज डेवलप्ड बाई DRDO. इट वॉज डेवलप्ड बाई DRDO. वेयर इज द हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ DRDO? इट इज इन न्यू दिल्ली. हु इज द चेयरमैन, चेयरमैन ऑफ DRDO? ही इज डॉक्टर GS सतीश रेड्डी, सतीश रेड्डी. ओके, देन इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इसरो, द चेयरमैन इज के सिवन एंड द हेडक्वार्टर इज इन बेंगलोर. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पार्टनर्ड विद ओडिशाज इंडस्ट्रियल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन टू सेटअप अ स्टेट ऑफ आर्ट प्लास्टिक पार्क एट पैरादीप. आई रिपीट, विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पार्टनर्ड विद ओडिशाज इंडस्ट्रियल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन टू सेटअप अ स्टेट ऑफ आर्ट प्लास्टिक पार्क एट पैरादीप. वन थिंग यू शुड नो अबाउट इज दिस इज द फर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ फुल्ली ऑपरेशनल प्लास्टिक पार्क. वेयर दिस इज बींग बिल्ट? इट इज बींग बिल्ट इन पैरादीप. वेयर इज पैरादीप? इट इज इन उड़ीसा. सो टेल मी विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पार्टनर्ड विद IDCO? द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट पार्टनर्ड विद IDCO वॉज इंडियन ऑयल कॉरपोरेशन लिमिटेड. इंडियन ऑयल कॉरपोरेशन लिमिटेड अलॉन्ग विद ओडिशाज इंडस्ट्रियल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन डिसाइडेड टू सेटअप अ प्लास्टिक पार्क एट पैरादीप. ओके, दिस इज द फर्स्ट फुल्ली ऑपरेशनल प्लास्टिक पार्क एट पैरादीप. इट विल बी डेवलप्ड इन ओडिशा. ऑल राइट, देन मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज विच कंट्री पार्टिसिपेटेड विद इंडिया इन द सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ डस्ट लीग 2, अ जॉइंट मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज दैट वॉज हेल्ड इन मार्च 2021 एट उत्तराखंड. सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ डस्ट लीग 2, वेयर वॉज द फर्स्ट एडिशन ऑफ इट हेल्ड? फर्स्ट टेल मी दिस. डस्ट लीग फर्स्ट एडिशन वॉज हेल्ड इन उज्बेकिस्तान. ओके, उज्बेकिस्तान. सो दिस मीन्स इंडिया इज हैविंग दिस एक्सरसाइज डस्ट लीग 2 विद उज्बेकिस्तान. सो द आंसर इज उज्बेकिस्तान. दिस वॉज द सेकेंड एडिशन. सो सेकेंड एडिशन इज कंडक्टेड इन इंडिया इन उत्तराखंड. ओके, फर्स्ट एडिशन टुक प्लेस इन उज्बेकिस्तान ओनली एंड सेकेंड एडिशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन उत्तराखंड. ऑल राइट, मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज रिसेंटली द कैबिनेट, यूनियन कैबिनेट गेव अप्रूवल फॉर द क्रिएशन ऑफ प्रधानमंत्री स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा निधि, दैट इज PMSSN. आई रिपीट, PMSSN stands for प्रधानमंत्री सुरक्षा, प्रधानमंत्री स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा निधि. विच मिनिस्ट्री विल एडमिनिस्ट्रेट द प्रधानमंत्री स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा निधि? सो विच मिनिस्ट्री विल एडमिनिस्ट्रेट इट? दिस विल बी एडमिनिस्ट्रेट बाय वॉट? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. ओके, हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. ऑल्सो यू शुड नो दैट द कैबिनेट गेव अप्रूवल फॉर द अमेंडमेंट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस एक्ट, इंश्योरेंस एक्ट ऑफ 1938. दिस इज टू इंक्रीज द FDI लिमिट, टू इंक्रीज द FDI लिमिट टू 74%, विच वॉज अर्लियर 49%. ओके, इट हैज बीन, FDI लिमिट हैज बीन इंक्लूड, द NFI लिमिट इन द इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर हैज बीन इंक्रीज टू 74%, विच वॉज अर्लियर 49%. ओके, एंड दिस हैज बीन अमेंडेड ऑफ द अमेंडमेंट ऑफ द इंश्योरेंस एक्ट दैट केम इन 1938. ओके, सो मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज वेयर इज इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पावर प्लांट विद द कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ 100 MW इज लोकेटेड? आई रिपीट, इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पावर प्लांट विद हैज अ कैपेसिटी ऑफ 100 MW where it is located. It is located in Telangana. Okay, it is located in Pedapalli, Telangana. Important thing to remember about is this 100 megawatt capacity. Then it will be developed by 2021. Okay, it is being developed by NTPC South. Okay, NTPC. What is NTPC? NTPC stands for National Thermal Power Corporation Limited. Okay, National Thermal Power Corporation Limited. And it is being developed over which reservoir? It is being developed over Shri Ram Sagar Reservoir. Ram Sagar Project Reservoir. Okay, important thing to remember about this. India's largest floating solar power plant will be developed in Telangana. And it is in the district of Pedapalli. It is of 100 megawatt capacity. It will be developed by 2021. It is being developed by NTPC South, that is National Thermal Power Corporation Limited. And it is being developed over Shri Ram Sagar Project Reservoir. Alright, moving to the next. Next is which bank launched India's first wearable payment device, Wear NPay, that enables the customers with contactless payment facilities. I repeat, which bank launched India's first wearable payment device, that is Wear NPay, that enables the customer to do contactless payment, and it is being done by Axis Bank. It is being done by Axis Bank. You should know Axis Bank is the India's third largest sector bank. I repeat, Axis Bank is the India's third largest private sector bank. Which stands at first position and second position? Comment below. This is your homework. Okay, homework. Which is the first and the second largest private sector bank? Comment below. Okay, then Axis Bank was developed in 1994. It was developed in 1994, and the MD and CEO of Axis Bank is Amitabh Chaudhry. Amitabh Chaudhry. Alright. Okay, moving on to the next. Next is, which bank topped the digital payment score released by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology for 3 consecutive months? I repeat, which bank topped the digital payment scorecard released by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology for 3 consecutive months? It was topped by whom? It was topped by State Bank of India. It was topped by State Bank of India. Then who is the chairman of State Bank of India? The chairman is Dinesh Kumar Khara. It is Dinesh Kumar Khara. Alright. Then headquarter of SBI is in Mumbai. What is the tagline of SBI Bank? It is the banker to every Indian. The banker to every Indian. This is the tagline of SBI. Okay. State Bank of India. Alright. Moving on to the next. Next is, who was awarded with the BBC Indian Sportsperson of the Year 2020? Who was awarded with the BBC Sportsperson of the Year 2020? Who was he? Who was he? He was Koneru Hampi. Koneru Hampi. Okay. He is a chess player. First of all, you should know this. He is a chess player, and question can be framed like, from which sports did Koneru Hampi belong to, and what award was given to Koneru Hampi? It was BBC Indian Sports Person of the Year 2020. Okay, he is from chess play. He is a chess player, and he is from which state? He is from Andhra Pradesh. He is from Andhra Pradesh. Okay, and you should know this is the second edition. This is the second edition of the award. Okay, sorry, excuse me. Okay, so this is the second edition award, and you should know that this award has been given on the basis of public votes. Okay, it has been given on the basis of public votes. Okay, moving on to the next. Next is, which country partnered with Russian space agency Roscosmos for jointly building an international lunar scientific research station? For developing an international lunar scientific research station, Roscosmos has partnered with which country? It has partnered with China. It has partnered with China, that is China National Space Administration, CNSA. It is of China, that is China National Space Administration. Then Roscosmos is of Russia. Alright, India Space Agency is ISRO. USA Space Agency is NASA. Okay, SpaceX. SpaceX is of Elon Musk. And Blue Origin. Blue Origin is of Jeff Bezos. Jeff Bezos, who is the founder of whom? He is the founder of Amazon. Okay, and also Blue Origin. Then you should also know, apart from this, there are some lunar missions coming up. Lunar missions coming up. First is Luna 27. It is being projected to be by 2025. Luna 27. And this is being launched by Russia. Luna 27. Second is of China. China will be launching Chang'e 7 by 2024. These are the two upcoming lunar missions that you should know. Alright, moving on to the next. Next is, by which year Indian fintech sector is expected to reach a valuation of USD 150 to 160 billion as per the report India Fintech, a USD 100 billion opportunity released by the Boston Consulting Group. I repeat, there was a report by the name India Fintech, a USD 100 billion opportunity that is being released by Boston Consulting Group and FICCI, that the India will reach a valuation of 150 to 160 billion dollar. So what is the, by which year Indian fintech sector is expected to reach a valuation of 150 to 160 billion dollar? By which year it is been expected? It is that by 2025, Indian fintech sector is expected to reach a valuation of 150 to 160 billion dollar as per the report released by the Boston Consulting Group and FICCI. Okay, chalo, moving on to the next. Next is, in which country the first of its kind India Energy Office was inaugurated that aims at expanding bilateral investment in the energy sector? I repeat, in which country the first of its kind India Energy Office, that is IEO, was inaugurated? It was inaugurated in Russia. Must know, this is most important question. The question can be framed like, which country's office was inaugurated in India related to energy? So, or it can be like, in India Energy Office was inaugurated in which country? It was inaugurated in Russia. So you should know this. Okay, it is a bilateral investment in the energy sector. Next is, which country partnered with Australia in conducting the world's first trial on producing hydrogen from brown coal? I repeat, so it is asking that Australia is conducting the world's first trial on producing hydrogen from brown coal. So which country partnered with Australia? The country that partnered with Australia is Japan. Okay, in producing hydrogen from brown coal. Okay, then moving on to the next. Which bank was removed by RBI from its prompt corrective action framework? I repeat, which bank was removed by the RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, from its prompt corrective action framework? So what is the name of the bank? The name of the bank is IDBI Bank. IDBI Bank was removed by RBI from its prompt corrective action framework. Next question is saying, recently SEBI formed a group of experts under its primary market advisory committee to check the feasibility to implement SPACs. What does SPAC stand for? Directly it is asking the full form of SPACs. As I always mention you, whenever there is a full form or any organization name, you should definitely know the full form of it. See, the question is just asking the full form of SPAC. So what is the full form of SPAC? The full form is Special Purpose Acquisition Companies. Okay, SPAC stands for Special Purpose Acquisition Companies. Next is, which organization received the King Bhumoil World Soil Day 2020 award for its contribution in creating awareness on the importance of healthy soils? I repeat, which organization received the King Bhumi Bol World Soil Day 2020 award? Which organization received this award? This award, that is the name by King Bhumi Bol World Soil Day 2020 award, was received by ICAR, that is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. Okay, then moving on to the next question. What is the theme of the 2021's World Kidney Day? What is the theme of 2021 World Kidney Day? The theme is kidney health for everyone, everywhere, living well with kidney disease. I repeat, kidney health for everyone, everywhere, living well with kidney disease is the theme of World Kidney Day of 2021. Okay, you should also remember that this is observed on the second Thursday of March. Next question is, world's first transgender community desk launched in Gachibowli police station, where it is located? I repeat, world's first transgender community desk launched by the Gachibowli. First transgender community desk launched by the Gachibowli police station. Where it is launched? It is launched in Telangana, Hyderabad. Or it is launched in Hyderabad, Telangana. Okay, then next question. Next question is, as per PwC's 24th annual global CEO survey, India emerged as the most attractive growth destination in the world. India has been emerged as the fifth most attractive growth destination in the world, and this report was given by the survey of 24th annual global CEO survey. Apart from this, you should also know that this, which is the most attractive growth destination in the world, the first rank was secured by USA, second was secured by China, okay, and our beloved India secured fifth rank. All right, then moving on to the next question, and this is the last question for the day. The question is, PM Modi participated in the first ever leader level summit of Quad countries that was held virtually. Which of the following decisions were taken during the summit? First, provide 1 billion doses of COVID-19 vaccine to Asia by 2022. Second was organizing a climate working group. Third was creating a travel bubble among the Quad countries. And fourth was cooperation towards an open and free Indo-Pacific region. So what were the decisions taken by the PM Modi in the first ever leader summit of Quad countries that was held virtually? The decisions that were taken was, first was providing 1 billion doses of COVID-19 vaccine to Asia by 2022. Second was organizing a climate working group. And the third was cooperation towards an open and free Indo-Pacific region. So the answer is fourth option, that is only 1, 2, and 4th. All right, very good. Then apart from this, I'll give you one more question for your homework. Tell me who is the election commissioner. Just name the election commissioner of India. Okay, this is your homework. I hope you like the session, and if you like the session, do like our video and subscribe to our channel. That will help us to motivate and make very good videos. So Vikas signing off. Take care.